Mike Gallagher.
Continuing in the ReliefFactor.com studios, we've a big week. I mean, we had a tremendous event last night, the Liberty Forum in the San Francisco Bay Area, Mountain View, with my my friend and colleague Michael Medved. It was also the President's State of the Union address last night, and it gives us an opportunity to kind of dive in to job creation and the economy and tax cuts. And jobs. As somebody who knows that as well as anybody, the president and CEO of Job Creators Network, Alfredo Ortiz, who we have worked with on and off for a long time now. Job Creators Network is one of the most important and significant organizations in the country right now, particularly with the state of the economy. Before he became the president and CEO of Job Creators Network, Alfredo was vice president of CSM Baker Products Food Service Division, a little $2 billion global food company. It's great to welcome back on our guest line the president and CEO of Job Creators Network, Alfredo Ortiz. Thanks so much for spending some time with us, Alfredo. How have you been?
I have been great, Mike. Always a pleasure to be on your show. Thank you very much.
Well, it's great to have you back, especially now where we're seeing some economic numbers that are fairly staggering. I mean, we continue, even the mainstream media, which has been fairly hostile, or I guess I should say openly hostile, to the president and his policies and his personality, have had to acknowledge we're seeing some incredibly strong unemployment numbers, economic numbers, the GDP, and so much. The president said on the campaign trail, jobs. You wait and see. The economy will come roaring back under a Trump presidency. Alfredo, it's hard to disagree with that assessment, isn't it?
Mike, it's very hard to disagree with that assessment. It is a true success. And one thing we are seeing almost automatically is that tax cuts work. We knew that they were going to work. That's why we pushed hard for it. That's why we fought hard for it. And especially in the small business environment, which, Mike, you know that's what we really push for, is, you know, more for our small businesses, where two-thirds of new job growth is really created. These tax cuts are working. We had a conference call last week with a lot of our members, and we heard over and over where these members were saying, we're going to pay our people more, we're going to add lines, we're going to add capacity. We are feeling great about the economy. We're feeling great about our business. And I tell you, overall, you hear that kind of confidence. A couple of years back, I have to tell you, Mike, I was on the road. As you know, you and I remember we started in Orlando with that little Bring Small Business Back tour where it first kind of came to light. And I heard, you know, people just were so downtrodden on their businesses, and there was a lack of optimism. And it is completely the opposite now, Mike. And we're seeing that, and people are investing right back. Not only big companies again, but the small companies, the medium-sized companies that we really fight for, we're hearing it from them as well.
It's why I'm drawn to Job Creators Network, because I have such a fondness for entrepreneurs, for people who say, you know what, against all odds, I'm going to try to create something out of nothing. I'm going to create a business. And yet for too many years, as you and I discussed, and as I watched you on that tour, you kept saying over and over again, the regulatory stranglehold that the government has had on entrepreneurs has made it almost impossible to succeed. That has really, really changed dramatically, hasn't it?
It really has. I mean, under the Trump administration, this regulation reduction campaign, I guess as they're calling it, I mean, it has done amazing things in terms of really being able to free up Americans to innovate and prosper. And that was, unfortunately, under the Obama administration, was almost completely taken away. In fact, we were seeing some of the lowest numbers ever. And at one point, we saw actually more businesses going away than were being created. The first time in history, we're seeing this confidence coming back. We're seeing people invest back in their businesses. And again, you know, I'm talking to small business owners across the country. And in fact, we're kicking off year three of our tour, going back out there talking to, you know, American public. And we're not talking, you know, the large corporation. We're talking Main Street America that we're talking to, Main Street small businesses, you know, the dry cleaner down the street, the burger guy down the street. We're talking to the folks that really are the backbone of America. We want to know what they're doing with their tax cuts. We're hearing this left and right from them that they're reinvesting back in their businesses. But this, you know, the anti-regulation environment, really, that Trump has created in the administration, I mean, I think we're at 26 regulations have been removed for every one that's being introduced. And I think the latest number I saw on that, Mike, is that it's about over $8 billion pretty much that has been saved from this regulatory rollback. That's $8 billion that companies, small, medium, or large, have to invest back in their businesses and back into their people.
Sure. Alfredo Ortiz is with us here on the Mike Gallagher Show. He's the president and CEO of Job Creators Network. The president taking a bit of a victory lap with his State of the Union. He also made a big point of urging bipartisanship and collaboration during the State of the Union. Alfredo, it's really kind of hard to extract the drama, the soap opera, the battling with the media, you know, the reporters bellowing and yelling at Sarah Sanders every afternoon at the White House press briefing, with the bipartisan nature or the nonpartisan nature of what it means to be a jobs creator, what it means to own a business or run a business. A lot of people, they're not really consumed with whether you're on the right or the left. They want to meet payroll. They want to be successful. They want their employees to be successful. Do you think the president has a chance of that message of bipartisanship and collaboration to resonate within the American people?
Well, Mike, I really hope so, because, you know, at the end here, what we're talking about, these are the lives of Americans, right? They're not Democratic Americans or Republican Americans or independent Americans. These are Americans in general, overall, period. In my article that I did, column on USA Today, I quoted the late senator and presidential candidate Paul Tsongas, who said, "You can't be pro-jobs and anti-business."
Right.
And the reality is that Democrats, that's all they seem to know. And I think what that really shows is just a complete lack of understanding of what it takes, especially on the small business side. I'm sorry, but, you know, I ran my own small business. I know the blood, sweat, and tears that I put into that. For over a year, I didn't actually take a salary. And I know many other small business owners out there that do the exact same thing. They pay their people first, and they put everything on the line to follow their American dream. And before, you know, the previous administration was killing these American dreams. And I'm here to tell you, Mike, what I'm hearing is that the American dream is alive and true today. And I can't be more excited about that. And we really have to thank the Trump administration for pulling this off and really doing in 1 year an amazing amount for our economy and for American people.
You know, I read your piece in USA Today. When you talk about Paul Tsongas saying you can't be pro-jobs and anti-business, it's also, hey, I hate to drag you into a political conversation, but many conservatives who kind of held their breath at President Trump's election have to be pleased because, let's face it, pro-jobs, pro-growth, pro-business, that's the ultimate conservative position, isn't it?
It really is pro-jobs and pro-business. I mean, that really is what we're talking about. And at the end, I think that is what propelled Trump to his victory. He understood that. He understood what the forgotten man in this country, what they were saying, what they were standing for, what they were missing.
Right.
And, you know, when we went on that bus tour, Mike, you heard it, if you remember, again, back in Orlando, you heard that from a couple hundred of folks there that they were standing up. They weren't identifying themselves as Democrat or Republican.
No, they
didn't
care.
They were identifying themselves as small business owners.
As business owners. Right. I want to hold that thought, because I want to get into what the Trump policies have meant to the average business owner and employee here in America. More with Alfredo Ortiz as we continue here on this Wednesday edition of the Mike Gallagher Show. Stay with us. Continuing this Wednesday edition from the ReliefFactor.com studios in San Francisco. We're in the studios of 860 AM, The Answer. And just a very, very powerful State of the Union address this week by the President of the United States. Our guest is Alfredo Ortiz, who's the President and CEO of Job Creators Network. A perfect guest, a perfect conversation to have in the times that we're exploring right now and watching and kind of holding on for dear life. Alfredo, the president made such a big deal about his economy in his speech, about the economy, the state of affairs. I want to share with you what Nancy Pelosi said about, I'm sure you've read this, you've heard this, about the bonuses that, thousands and thousands of Americans are getting. The Home Depot and airlines industry and so many companies are handing out bonuses now because of the president and the GOP's tax reform plan. And yet Mrs. Pelosi seemed to mock that. Let's listen together.
In terms of the bonus that corporate America received versus the crumbs that they are giving to workers to kind of put the schmooze on is so pathetic. It's so pathetic.
Alfredo, I cannot tell you how many emails, text messages, and calls I've gotten from people saying, I'm so grateful for a $1,000 bonus or a $2,000, $2,500 that I can't see straight. And I got to tell you, you talk about being out of touch with reality. For Nancy Pelosi to say these are crumbs, these are pathetic crumbs, wow, can you spell tone deaf?
Yeah, Mike, I have to tell you, I mean, I'm sitting here just shaking my head because it's really unbelievable. It's actually so demeaning and belittling the way, you know, and condescending. I'm sorry, but it's just unbelievable that tone. That she takes $1,000 for a lot of people is a lot of money. You know, growing up poor myself, I mean, I remember I used to go around on trash day picking up, you know, aluminum cans and newspapers. And, you know, that was like our grocery money. We'd cash that in. That was our grocery money. I mean, you know, $50 or whatever. That was our grocery money for the week. I mean, $1,000 would be like we won the lotto, right? I mean, and, you know, some people, for average Americans who can't spend $400, you know, on an unexpected, you know, auto repair bill, $1,000 is a tremendous amount of money. And it really just shows, again, to your point, how out of touch and this elitist attitude. And Mike, I know we're actually even talking a lot about these bonuses of $1,000, but I want to take a moment to also talk about the minimum wage increases and the wage increases that we're hearing from these companies as well. Because one thing that nobody's really focusing on, and we're going to be talking more about this, is if you look at an average full-time employee is about 2,000 hours, right, in a year. If they're getting $1 an increase per hour, that's $2,000 more plus a bonus on top of it. So if they get, let's say, $2 in a year, that's $4,000 plus a $1,000 bonus. We're talking, you know, that's a tremendous amount of money. And that's not even being discussed as much as the bonuses are. But, real money for a lot of people.
Of course it is. And there are moments where different politicians, I think, say things that they might wish they could undo or could have a do-over. For Hillary Rodham Clinton, maybe it was referring to the basket of deplorables, and deplorables became such an important, you know, rallying point for so many people. I got to tell you, Alfredo, when I hear Nancy Pelosi talk about crumbs and pathetic crumbs, maybe that's one of those aha moments again where people say, wait a minute, I'm not being represented in Washington the way I want to be represented anymore. And I've got a billionaire president who is fighting hard for entrepreneurs and working class Americans.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I'll tell you this, Mike. I mean, my sister's a teacher. She makes $15 an hour. I mean, you know, I asked her what did she think about that comment of, you know, $1,000 being, you know, crumbs. And she goes, hey, I'll take those crumbs any day because that's a lot of money to me.
Sure,
that's a lot of hours.
Sure it is.
You know,
sure it is.
And so Mike, it's amazing and it's sad. But fortunately, we do have a president that understands what this means to, you know, the average American, is fighting for the average American. And again, our small business owners, that Job Creators Network, we've been fighting for, you know, really from day one of, you know, this organization started, but especially over the past few years. And I'll tell you, we're going to keep on fighting that fight because there are 30 million small business owners out there that employ about 60 million people. You know, and really, again, it's the backbone of America. And where all the new job growth really happens. So, you know, we're thankful, and I'll tell you that a lot of all of our members that I've heard from so far are all very thankful that they're seeing what they're seeing.
You can go to jobcreatorsnetwork.com to learn more about Alfredo's organization. Alfredo Ortiz, of course, with us, the president and CEO of Job Creators Network. You could also follow them on Twitter at Job Creators USA. You wrote in your USA Today piece about the public opinion about the state of our economy versus the glowing economic indicators. And yet, when a lot of us hear public opinion, you get this impression that there's such, again, I got to use the word drama or melodrama or the soap opera antics of the media and Twitter and all the stuff that goes on with this president. And yet the public opinion when it comes to spending and consumer confidence, it's remarkably high, isn't it?
It is. Consumer confidence, to your point, remains near a 17-year high. And that in of itself is just an amazing feat. And I know consumers are continuing feeling good about this. When we start seeing these withholding tables and on roughly mid-February, people are going to start seeing their paychecks increase little by little as companies really put these new tax rates in place. People are going to feel this more and more. I mean, not to be too boring to the listeners here, but when you start looking at some of these polls that also talk about would you vote for a Democrat or Republican, they call them these generic polls. Those numbers are closing up, Mike, and from double digits to single digits, it means that the consumer, the average American, is starting to go, wait a minute, I'm hearing this from CNN and CNBC and ABC, but I'm feeling this. So there's a disconnect. I'm looking at my 401k, and I'm seeing these things double-digit increase. I'm seeing my pensions are going up, and they're feeling much better. I mean, there is a big disconnect, I think, that American public is starting to say, wait a minute, maybe this is really fake news.
No kidding. I got a call Monday from a guy, I think he was in Phoenix, and he said, my mom works for the Home Depot, and she's been a Trump skeptic. He goes, I've been on board, but she was a President Trump skeptic. She wound up as a Home Depot employee getting that $1,000 bonus. He said she literally fell to the ground and cried. She was so excited and happy and grateful. And that's the kind—the 2018, Alfredo Ortiz, just might be the year that the rubber meets the road and people are starting to see that these economic policies of the Trump administration are dramatically improving this country and improving individuals' lives as well.
Yeah, absolutely. 2018 will definitely be that. And again, one of the things, Mike, that we've really moved forward now from moving from our Tax Cuts Now campaign to our Tax Cuts Work campaign, we want to make sure that the American public is getting this straight from the people who are the job creators of America, the small business owners. We're encouraging people to go to our site, taxcutswork.com, and send us your stories about what you're doing with the tax cut. What does that tax cut mean to you? Whether you're an individual or a small business owner or medium or even a large company, tell us your actual stories. That's nice. What we need to get out there, because right now, unfortunately, there is a lot of that fake news out there. But the American public is realizing, wait a minute, something is going on because I'm hearing this, but I'm feeling that. And
it's taxcutswork.com?
That's correct, Mike. Taxcutswork.com.
You got it. I hope everybody goes there, and I'm so grateful for the work you guys do. As you know, Alfredo, thanks for spending some time out of your day with us here on the Mike Gallagher Show. Keep fighting the good fight, sir.
We will. You too, and thank you for all you do, and thanks again, and God bless.
God bless.